Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to go ahead and call this meeting to order.
And you said she does our minutes.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, calling this meeting to order. This is the January meeting for the Louth County Valdosta Zoning Board of Appeals. For those of you that have never been here, let me quickly tell you how it operates so you can keep up. We will call each case by case name and case number. Staff will come to the lectern to give us the information concerning the case. Once staff has presented the information, there will possibly be discussions and/or questions among the board members, back and forth to staff. Once we have determined that we feel like we understand what's being asked, then I will ask if there is anyone here that would like to speak in behalf, or if the applicant is here and would like to give us any additional information. If so, please come to the lectern, give us your name and address for the record. Give us the information you would like for us to take under advisement. After you have given us the information, there will probably be discussions and/or questions among board members or back and forth to whoever's at the lectern in the time. If there are multiple people here in support, we would like to know if you have something you want to add, but please don't hammer us with the same thing over and over again. Give it to us the first time so we can take it under advisement and move on. I will then ask if there are any persons here in opposition or if any people have questions about what is being requested. If so, please come to the lectern, give us your name and address for the record, tell us what you are concerned about. We will try to take it under advisement or answer your questions. If there are multiple people, again, same thing. Please come, give us the information you want, but don't hammer us with the same thing over and over again. Once we have heard from both sides, we generally will make a decision here today. However, we do have it in bylaws. Should we feel like information is lacking or parties need to discuss, we can postpone action until the next regularly scheduled meeting. Okay, at this time, I have an announcement. The Louth County case number 2, which is VAR 2018-02 for SEP, S-E-E-P, LLC, 4232-4-Hour. That request has been withdrawn by the applicant. If you are here concerning that case, we will not hear anything about it. Should the applicant reapply or ask for other information, you will be notified again if you are concerned about whatever it is they are trying to do. Okay, Louth County case number 1, VAR 2018-01, Joan F. James, Maple Road, Valdosta. Ms. Martella.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. First case is a county case, Ms. Joan F. James. So the property is located on Maple Road. It is in an R1 zoning classification. This is a request for variance to the ULDC minimum design standards as it pertains to minimum lot width. You all will recall about a year ago we had a very similar request by the applicant's brother, whose property is just west of the subject property. And you know, again, this is a request where I wanted to take one application so we can address all 4 lots, but you know, for whatever reason, they are requesting separate variances. But this is a variance to our minimum lot width requirement. The applicant has been deeded this property by her mother. She wishes to record a survey plat. In reviewing the survey plat, we determined that the minimum lot width, as depicted on the survey, which is enclosed in your staff report, has a lot width of 105 feet, and 120 feet is the minimum requirement. Staff didn't have a problem with this request. It meets the intent of the ULDC, and as such, we are recommending approval of the request. I'll be more than happy to answer any questions.
Does anyone on the board? board have any questions or discussions at this time?
It appears on this map, and I went out there to the property too, that the boundary of what they're wanting to get variance on is encroaching on where the current mobile home is sitting next door.
Survey plat, does it depict that if there is an encroachment, I'm sure it'll come up in, you know, as part of the purchase.
That's a family member next door in that mobile home?
It is a family member.
Okay.
Or ex-family member.
Yeah, the drawing that we were given here is out of line with the actual property lines recorded on the tax.
Yeah, and those tax parcel lines could be off on, you know.
Well, and because this kind of situation is normally complaint or otherwise inspection driven, chances are we may never see it. Being that it's family, if it was somebody else, then I might be a little more concerned with, and like, Mr. Paul saying, just because the yellow line is on the picture, that yellow line can be off.
Yeah. Well, and if she puts any sort of dwelling on that, she has to meet setback.
Absolutely.
This property looked familiar to me whenever I was reviewing the packet. Can you remind me what we did before?
It was a property, if you look on your survey plat, the track that is identified as track number 3, that was a variance request about a year ago by Mr. Foster, Rufus Foster. He requested a variance to identical variance. He had a lot with the 105 feet, and the board granted him a variance, you know, so that he can record that plat at 105 feet wide. It's like the early or the last part of 2016, December 2016, I believe.
And was the problem created basically by a non-recorded plat? Is that?
It was created by the the way the mother left the will. She wanted, you know, each of the siblings to have an equal amount, and that was the best way for her to configure those lots. So for years and years, we had a deed, but no survey plat. The survey plat did come through, but it was not approved because of the lot. But now each of the siblings are at the point where they're ready to have the recorded plat along with the deeds.
Any other questions? Any other discussion? Is anyone here in support of this application?
Yes.
Was there anything you would like to add to?
No, not really.
And you are the applicant?
No, I'm a very good friend of the applicant.
Excuse me, could I get your name and address for the record?
Sure. My name is Lola. That's L-O-L-A, Lore, M-O-O-R-E. I reside at 603 South College Street in Hay Howard. The zip is 316-32.
Thank you.
Mr. Chairman, the applicant lives in Sacramento, California.
Well,
let's just give
her a jump. Come on.
So she didn't have, Mr. Rufus was going to come in her place, but she got Ms. Lola to come just in his board education.
Okay. Does the board have any questions that you might want to address to her to see if she might have an answer? Was there any contact to your office concerning this case, Carmella?
Yes, sir. The property owner across the street was just interested, more interested in anything. He wasn't in favor or against the request.
All right. Any other discussions, any other questions from the board before I ask a question, a follow-up question? Can I entertain a motion on this request? And by any means, it does not preclude either approval or denial simply because a prior case had been done. It's in my laws that each case stands on its own.
No, go ahead.
make a motion that we approve the request as presented, citing the deed.
Have a motion on the floor to approve the request as presented, citing criteria deeds. Second, Mr. McCall, all in favor, raise a hand. Unanimous, we love it, Lou. Okay, well, next case we'll call is City of Alachua case, application 2017-08, Williams Investment Company, 1003 North St. Augustine Road. Ms. Tracy.
Yes.
It's time for the Tracy Show.
Yes, sir, thank you.
And if I'm looking at the drawing correctly, they're asking for it to be somewhat in the center, it's still on the side of the property, but it is in the center of the property, not to what I would consider to be the rear of the property. How did that discussion go before talking about where they were proposing?
Matt and I had a discussion about the locations indicated on the site plans, it's on the screen that y'all are seeing in your packets. The determination was made that no variance was needed.
So he could put it pretty much anywhere on the property without any problems?
As long as...
Because there's no variance requested for that part. Any other questions, any other discussion?
Is the property to be subdivided? What's this line, this dash line?
I see the line, and I have shape of recognition, we process a subdivision plat, and no, at this point, we have no subdivision plat to break that property into two pieces. I don't know if it's in the plans, the applicant may be able to answer that question, but at this point, we have no plat that can break that property into two pieces. I'm not sure the line that presents it to you, but it has not been split.
Any other questions, any other discussion? Thank you, Tracy. Does anyone here, applicant or otherwise, would like to speak?
Good evening, I'm Mike Williams, I reside at 4611 Issue Circle in Valdosta. I'm here representing Williams Investment Company along with Brother Roman Law. Basically, like the lady had mentioned earlier, actually, if it was within the 1,500 feet of the interstate, everything that we're applying for signage-wise would be in full compliance, and there wouldn't be a need for a variance request. In regards to maximum allowable height, and actually, we're not trying to go as big and as massive. The biggest issue we have is the burden of the trees that are on the rear of the Best Buy building, of which we're trying to get up above with the visibility. In regards to creating favorable marketing advantages or whatever to us by us having a high rise, we're the only ones in a hotel type business that's outside of the 1,500 feet of the I-75. So actually, that's not really creating an advantage to us. Actually, it's somewhat leveling the playing field the way we do it. Naturally, the interstate traffic is very important to our business. Naturally, it's extended state product, which is in our opinion, a very good quality product. Something new to us, but naturally, we need to have the right to give our consumer to know where we are. And the only way we can do it, short of taking the trees out, which we don't own the land, it's in a ditch on the back side of the Best Buy, is to get some high rise up above. Actually, we could go up as high as about 200 feet. What we're proposing is basically around 110, 120 total footage. In regards to the outparcel in front, it is on the market. We're very, very selective in regards to what we will accept to go in front of. We've turned down some proposals and stuff, but we feel that it's very, we want to hold out for what would be complementary to our type of development, more so, say, a restaurant or something of that nature. Nationally, in the past, Norman Drive has been somewhat of a barrier as such as far as tourism is concerned. On St. Augustine Road, naturally everybody wants to be on St. Augustine Road. Naturally, in the very recent future, you got Cookout that's going next to Steak and Shake. You got Panera Bread that's going where the Mexican restaurant that burnt down. You have the Panda Express that's there. It's whatever that we end up putting in front of us is there. So with that said, I mean, wide open to answer any questions you might have. Rick's got all the detailed information. There is going to be a 24-foot sign out on the, right on St. Augustine Road, which is naturally below the maximum amount of footage and height restrictions and everything else. We'll be in full compliance of the sign ordinances and substantially below, with exception of outside of the 1,500 feet with our request.
Any questions?
I have a bunch of questions.
Ooh.
I went out there and I sat there and I thought, a high-rise sign is to get the attention of people on the interstate, right?
That as well as the traffic once they exit the interstate. I mean, you can basically go down as far as where the Huddle House is, past that, we've actually had cranes up there flying the flags and stuff. And it has very good visibility, particularly about where the country ends, right after you have to exit it off of the interstate.
Now, I know y'all are the experts, and you've done your homework on what draws people and everything, but I was real impressed with the way the hotel is going to look, and we need another extended stay hotel.
Sure.
But to me, a 120-foot tall sign is going to take away from the, this is extended stay. It's a home away from home for a lot of people.
It is.
It would be a turnoff for me. As far as the distance from the interstate, you've got your billboard signs that are going to advertise where you are. People, you're not going to be competing like other hotels because there are not a lot of y'all around. And the 120 feet tall in that particular spot would be an eyesore to me. Just might as well tell you.
I beg to differ. you back up and you look at, say, the Academy Sports Sign, for example. I don't know what the footage is, but it's substantially above 100.
Very familiar with it.
Naturally, you know, as the interstate, as it goes north, naturally it widens further away from Norman Drive. Mm-hmm. Actually, Norman Drive and the where the sign is located, Academy, for example, is going to be further away from Norman Drive as compared to where we would, because of I don't think so, Nancy. I mean, naturally, we've got a large investment there. And if we thought we were doing something to blacken the image of what we're doing, we would be focused.
It's very attractive.
And we are building a very quality product in regards to the rear of the property. Whatever. Naturally, the property is going to have St. Augustine address, which is very important. But technically, the building is facing here, which the backside to us, you could argue either way, is on the west side of the property, as compared to the north side of the property, whether or not you know. Just depends on what your address is.
Your entrance and exit to get access to it is going to be off of Hickory, not off of St. Augustine.
No, actually, we have curb cut on St. Augustine. We'll have access off of both St. Augustine as well as.
But you're not using the St. Augustine Avenue.
We are going to use the St. Augustine.
I thought you just said that you were using the Hickory Drive.
No, sir. It's very important that we use the St. Augustine address. But technically, that's the rear of the property because the property is facing Hickory, even though it's a St. Augustine address.
Okay. If I'm reading it right, and based on my interpretation, an extended stay means you're looking for somebody that is here for months, 3 or 4 months, several
sure.
weeks,
yes.
Either because they have family at South Georgia Medical, or they have a job renovating a building, or building some kind of property somewhere in close proximity. So, to me, sort of negates a little bit of the fact that you're trying to draw them off of the interstate. They're already committed to coming here, and you're one of, two, three extended stays in the area. So they're not going to be going to your other hotels that are designed for one or two nights or a weekend. They're gonna try to find you either way.
Yes, you'd like to think so, but that's not always the case. Technically, though, in what we do, this is our personal, okay? So, but our understanding in talking to different friends in the business and with the franchisors and everything, about 60% of our business will be in state. You got about 40% that you're going to be dependent on of the interstate.
Okay. Ask, I think you said you had a question, or was it you?
I have a question, but I was getting myself.
Any other questions? Any other discussions?
Chairman, can I make a point?
Yes.
Okay. You asked me a question earlier about the location of a high rise sign, whether or not it had to be in the rear yard or not. I went back and double checked the regulations to refresh my thinking. And it says such sign shall be set back at least 150 feet from any street right of way, and preferably located in the rear yard setback area. Preferably.
That's what I picked up. Maybe I'm missing preferably.
And I had to go back and look myself. I spelled it ballpark, and the location where they're showing it on the site plan is about as close as it can go to the right of
way. Any other questions, any other discussions?
Would it be oriented in the manner depicted on this proposed drawing?
Yes.
So it would be facing kind of towards what? Like
the it would be facing towards the west. It would be facing west.
Okay.
As far as visibility.
Any other questions, discussions?
Realistically, in regards to what we're talking about, actually, we don't view what we're talking about. And basically, it's an introduction to our customer. It's nothing that's damning. If we thought this was something that'd be damning to a project, I mean, quite frankly, this is a very expensive project. Just the sign itself is going to be 80+ thousand dollars. We would be crazy to put it out there. I mean, we don't want to spend money for the sake of spending money. Especially if it's a negative to us. But don't view it that way.
Personally, my concern is that once you supposedly get okay to build this, that somebody else in that general area says, hey, I want to draw some traffic off the interstate for my restaurant or whatever it is, and now we start getting others that want to start popping up in other areas, and that's my problem.
Well, I guess when it might be changed code.
The county code says,
I understand.
And the county commissioners start looking cross-eyed at us when we start gutting up there. So we have to, me personally,
yeah,
I have to look real hard at what I feel like I might be voting for or against as to what could follow it and what is going to be the problems for the next person that wants to do it or the problems that we may be creating for the county commission, because Lord knows they got enough on their plate now.
Well, an argument there would be the case that National River, the only hotel outside of the 1,500-foot band. So.
But I
that's an excuse anyway.
But what if one of the restaurants down there says, I need more exposure, I want to come off the interstate to eat with me, I want to put 120 or 150 foot sign there, and they are 3,000 plus away as the crow flies, 4,000 plus feet away. That's my point. You know, it would also begin with a proliferation of these real big signs, not necessarily in this area only, but as you get further down to Hill Avenue, or if they're on the other side of the interstate, then that's one of my concerns.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If you don't get this signed, what signage will be there?
We'll have a 24-foot sign out on the Townsley Road.
And will there be a sign on the face of the building?
Yes. But it's still, again, behind the trees. I'm going to look behind Best Buy, that ditch that's through there. I mean, it's...
Is there a left...
I've never seen water in it, but it's, there's trees just stay around.
Is there a left turn, is making the left turn on the Hickory? How hard is that? How hard is it to make that left?
There's a turning lane there.
There's a turning lane. So, okay. Thank you.
But you have to be down there talking about the building sign, and you have to be there with pass, and ask the Best Buy or whatever in order to see it. Nothing nowhere near the visibility we're talking about. Like I said, we could go up technically if we were inside of the 1,500 feet up to 200 feet. All we want to do is get up high enough to get above the tree, which is about 110 foot.
Any other questions? Any other discussion?
Mr. Chairman, Mr. Chairman.
They go to the lectern, give us your name and address, so we can have it for the record. You can do it right there. You don't need your name and address for the record.
Rick Williams, 3331 Plantation Drive, Valdosta. No Williams Investment Company. You know, we're a family business, as Mike made reference to earlier. You know, we're based out of here, originally based out of Adel. Many of us moved here back in the 70s when I started at Valdosta State, etc. So, you know, Valdosta's home. And certainly, we don't want to do anything to be a detriment to the community. You know, we own... last year, we built a Comfort Inn and Suites, a beautiful new hotel next to the Holiday Inn Hotel, which we own. And so we've got several properties here. And you know, we take pride in trying to do a good job and actually award-winning type hotels here. So it's exciting to us to do what we're doing. And this is our first entry into the extended stay version. And actually, it was really close to what we do. It was closer to the 50-50 mix. You expect about 50% of our 30-plus day stays, and then about 50% of our overnighters. So we do have a core of extended stay, which we're pretty pleased with. That's one of the things that helps make the model pretty good, you know, favorable towards development. You know, so with the, so we are depending, you know, on a lot of the overnighters for the short terms, less than three. So we're thinking of roughly 50% of 30-plus days. But again, that's leading 50%. You're looking to have more of our typical hotels. We're doing, you know, with this regard to the signage on the walls at the on the building, truly, from what we can tell, it is blocked. I imagine most of you had a chance to look at the visibility of the building, and really, you can't really see the building through the trees. So we were just feeling that the signage, which would be approvable if we were within that 1,500 feet, the high-rise signage would be very much complementary. And while it would not be seen from the interstate itself, it could be seen from pretty close to the interchange, as Mike mentioned, around the country or whatever you can start. And we did put the cranes out there to kind of recognize what height we thought it needed to be, and without really just jacking it up within what the law allows of a couple hundred feet. We said this is what should be a reasonable appearing, looking, you know, back to the what we think of a compliment, what we're trying to do. And it goes, clearly you would have to get almost beside us to see a hotel, to see our signage of the hotel itself, if we don't have this high-rise signage. And so we, you know, there's a lot of nice properties there, but there's a lot of things that we think that would be helpful. The recognition of our brand. And again, we do think it'll complement the area. And we're excited that Cookout is coming down that way, and also that Panera Bread and some other things. And, you know, but we just feel it's important to us, and we want to make it part of our continued family production. So we appreciate all of your time and consideration.
Any questions, any discussions for the leader?
I've got a question. Who owns those trees? The people that have Best Buy?
The people that own the shopping centers of Best Buy and those other. There's a couple of different owners that are in there.
Actually, there's five different owners. We're by Columbus, some Indians out of North Florida, the dentist, Grantham.
correctly.
Have y'all talked to anybody, any of the owners, about cutting some of the trees?
I don't know that they can because of requirements for vegetative buffering and whatnot, and landscape, but they might be covered.
They're on, we're going against commercial now. When that was, that buffering was required, when it was commercial against residential, but now they're commercial against commercial.
My opinion. Tracy?
Gracious, right, this particular parcel was rezoned within the past year, 2 months, on rezone to community commercial from residential zoning district. I believe the trees are on, Vestal property, but I would have to consult with the city arborist and landscaping folks to be able to find out what landscaping possibilities, tree possibilities there are.
Okay, thank you. Any other questions? Any other comments anybody else would like to do?
Well, everybody looks mad.
I'm hearing support, brother, my name is Chris.
No, that's fine.
Okay.
Okay, anybody here in opposition to this request, raise your hands. Was there any contact to your office, Tracy, about this request? Okay, ladies and gentlemen, any discussion, any questions that you wanna air out before I try to call for a motion? Can I get a motion on this request? Everybody shout it, man.
Nobody pressed my
motion. Somebody's got to do something.
I'll make a motion. I'll make the motion that we follow the staff recommendation and find it inconsistent with the variance review criteria and deny the request.
I have a motion on the floor from Ms. Boardman to deny the request. Just here in a second.
I second.
All right, we have a second from Nancy. All in favor of denying the request as presented, please raise a hand. All opposed, please raise a hand. And I get to earn my pay this one. As tough as it is, I thought long and hard about this one when I looked at it, because I was afraid this was going to come down to eventually me. And I'm going to vote no, but I don't think it's the right thing to do that far away.
Yes.
If what?
You're going to vote yes.
I'm sorry, I'm going to vote yes. No to the sign, yes to the motion, I'm sorry. Because I think it's a little bit too far for us to be pushing the envelope 3,000 to 4,000 feet as opposed to 1,500. So my vote is in support of the motion and denial of the sign. The vote is 4-3.
Thank you for your consideration.
Thank you for your consideration. Yes, sir. And it was a lot of consideration. I spent a lot of time working through it in the hope that it wouldn't come down to me, but it did.
Yeah.
Well, the thing is, if you don't ask, then you said no to yourself.
That's right. Thank you so much. Nice
all right.
To
okay. As far as other business, we have approval of the minutes. I had a couple of the additions and corrections that I had previously called Tracy about. Does anybody else have anything?
I will tell you that I updated the minutes, the draft minutes, per Mr. Strickland and my conversation. Changes are made in yellow and highlighted. There were a couple that I made that Mr. Strickland and I didn't talk about on the phone. One of them was the date I had left. I had the November meeting. changes for December. And I had both, I had Mr. Hovey both there and absent. And you can't be both there and absent. So he was technically absent, so I took away his name and your posture. And that's where the only two changes that I made. Well, other than what Mr. Strickland had.
Anybody else have any additions, deletions, corrections? Can I get a motion to accept the minutes with the corrections?
Make a motion to accept the minutes.
Got a motion from Mr. Hall, do I have a second? I heard a second. Have a second, yes. All in favor, raise a hand. Thank you. I also want to take a moment to thank Nancy for hosting the Christmas get together. Thank you very much.
Didn't you leave?
It was great. Those of you that made it, know about it. Those of you that didn't make it for whatever reason, you missed a good time. Is there any other new business, old business, anything we need to talk about?
How about the county doesn't have any cases for your next meeting? I'm not sure that's.
We have at least one, and I think there might be a second. So I will see you.
Okay. Anything old business, anything we need to discuss, anything going on? Ladies and gentlemen, we stand adjourned. Thank you for your time and trouble.
Yeah, I saw.